Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I'll explain how to use a USB flash driver on NuttX. Are you ready? Then let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space, NuttX. Execute make this clean to clear previous configuration. Now we can start the board configuration. Tools, configure.sh, stm32f4discover/nsh. Now execute make menu config to enable the option to get the USB flash driver working. First, we need to change our build host platform from Windows to Linux because we are compiling it on Linux. So we can exit. We also need to double check if the USB OTG full speed support is enabled. So enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, and verify if the OTG FS is enabled. Okay, it is enabled. We can exit. Exit again. Go to RTOS features, RTOS hooks, and enable custom board driver initialization. Exit. Go to work queue support. Enable high priority kernel work thread. Exit. Exit again. Go to device drivers and move down to USB host driver support. Enable it. We need to disable isochronous endpoint support to reduce the driver size. And we need to enable mass storage class. We can exit. Exit again. Go to file system. Enable the fetch file system. We can also enable fetch upper and lower names and fetch long names support. Exit. And finally, exit and save. We can execute make to compile the source code. Okay, the compilation is done. Now all we need is a micro USB to USB cable. Plug the USB flash driver on it. And plug the micro USB in the STM32F4 discovery board. We need to flash the firmware inside the board, so execute, open OCD, okay, it flashed the firmware inside the board. Now we can run minicom, reset the board, and let's see if the USB flash driver was detected. ls/dev. Okay, it was detected. Now we can mount it. Mount vfet/dev/sda2mnt. Let's see what is inside it. Okay, that is a music directory and a hello.txt. Let's see this hello.exe file. Very nice. It just shows the content of the file. Now we can also create some file. For example, this is a new file to mnt new file.txt lsmnt again. Okay, there is a new file in the USB flash drive. Let's show its content to confirm it is correct. Okay, basically that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video. If you are not subscribed to NuttX channel yet, please subscribe and click in the bell to receive notification when I post a new video. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.